Iran's Qaher-313 fifth-generation fighter jet, challenge US F-35, F-22 Raptors? February 2013, Iran rolled out its fifth-generation Qaher-313 stealth fighter jet in presence of President Mahmoud Ahmadinejad, supposedly the country's most advanced warplane. The jet, initially greeted with skepticism, became a laughing stock among the military enthusiasts, who dismissed it as a crude mock-up and a stunt designed to impress the domestic audience. The military aviation experts, after taking a cursory look at the images and videos released by Iran showing the fighter jet, said it was simply impossible for this prototype to even fly. Iran continued to assert that its newest fighter jet was real and already flying. The country's government insisted the aircraft was even superior to Lockheed Martin F-22 Raptor and the F-35 Joint Strike Fighter and would be operational soon. The Q-313 single-engine aircraft was far too small to perform and had too many engineering flaws to even qualify as a fourth-generation jet. The jet features hard edges and those distinctive edges and angle of the US F-22 and the twin tail shape much similar to that of the F-35 Lightning II, the aviationist concluded. The fighter has large, fixed canards, with the external section of the little wings canted downward. Q-313 is built with a nose section that is so small that almost no radar could fit in it. Now the most important part, the air intakes, which are so small that it reminds you of drones with similar intake sizes. The engine afterburners would melt the entire jet. Billed as the country's most advanced indigenous fighter jet, Q-313 is so small that there literally isn't enough space under its wings for the bombs and missiles that the country claimed it could carry. It doesn't even have a weapons bay. The cockpit is so small that it can't accommodate a normal pilot in the ejection seat. Iran tried to reinforce confidence in the world community by releasing a video showing the fighter jet flying. Aircraft was superior to F-22 and the F-35 fighters and would be operational soon. So, where's the aircraft now? The project has apparently disappeared with no further talk heard about its viability or future operational plans, as expected. In a televised interview after unveiling the new jet, Iran's Defense Minister Amir Hatami said, "We have learned in the Iran-Iraq war that we cannot rely on anyone but ourselves. Our resources are limited and we are committed to establishing security at a minimum cost." The US State Department refuted Iran's claim of its newest fighter jet being of domestic origin, saying, "It seems that regime officials are not sufficiently familiar with the development of the aviation industry." While the Iran developing a fifth-generation fighter jet that could challenge the air superiority of its rivals still remains a dream. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe.